a famous emblem of the region. I can admire the great work of art from here. Anyone who would use this chalice made of solid gold for mass would be exhausted just trying to lift it. Some may like to live a life full of excess. I, for one, have devoted mine to self-denial. Strong and robust. I assume the abbot puts the less sumptuous things here for safekeeping. It's empty. Gracious! It's made of gold. I do love music, but I couldn't say which instrument that is. It looks like a cross between a lute and a fiddle. Even if I were a musician, I wouldn't dare touch it. I can see the library, the church, and the hospital from here. Why should I have to climb out through the window? They're made of silk filled with down. No doubt they're quite a bit more comfortable than the beds in our cells. Let's take a look. The Life and Miracles of San Mateo de Vejer. Saint Gabriel, a legend of our time. Revelations of Saint Evaristus. Nothing interesting, with all due respect for the saints, of course. That's what the abbot is reading. In light of the opulence of this hall, I can easily imagine how it looks inside. I don't think going in there is part of the freedom of movement the abbot has authorized for me. Weighs more than Bruno's thoughts. I'd rather see it here on the floor than on a battlefield. Praise the Lord, it wasn't used. It doesn't show any traces. Well forged. It must weigh quite a bit. I think I'd rather employ all my faculties towards solving this case. During the battles, I'll make use of additional tried and true methods.
Brother Leonardo, any news?
No, not yet. Only theories.
Then why have you come?
Father, it's imperative that I obtain access to the upper halls of the library.
That's out of the question. As you know, the rules of this abbey forbid.
But?
It's useless. You're not going to persuade me.
I was just passing by, but I'm headed off again.
In that case, go with my blessing, and keep me informed.
It's burning like it would in the eponymous inferno. I should literally put my hand in the fire? That's a rolling pin for kneading dough. I hope we're having something other than soup to eat this evening. I can put these to good use.
It's full of holes! I ordered a new one, but it hasn't arrived yet. To fan the fire, I just use what I have on hand.
No need to fan a fire here. And besides, I've got the impression that it's broken. It's locked. Nothing interesting. It's only logical that he's so busy. He cooks for the entire community. Forgive me for interrupting you, brother.
Oh, none other than our special guest. You're not interrupting me, Brother Leonardo. My name is Martin, and as you can see, I'm the cook. How can I help you?
The soup you're cooking there smells, if you'll pardon me, heavenly.
Really?
Yes, I see that you're adding chicken bones and some spices. Not everyone takes so much trouble with such a simple dish as soup.
Could be, but I do. And by the way, in this case, I must share the compliment with Brother Ladio. He supplies me with the spices.
The appearance and aroma are incomparable.
I see you appreciate good cooking.
What shall I say? I have traveled quite a bit.
It's a pleasure to talk with a connoisseur.
That's kind, but connoisseur would be a mouthful.
Oh, don't be so modest, brother. You recognized a decent soup by its fragrance. I presume that you're able to sniff out the spices that were used, too.
My sense of smell is not up to snuff today.
Really?
Can we talk about Anselmo, brother?
Anselmo? Oh, blessed Mother of God. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo et Spes Nostra Salve. Ad te clamamus exsulses filii Evae, ad te suspirarnos gementes et fientes in hac lacrimarum valle. Eia ergo advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O dulcis Virgo Maria, ora pro nobis sancta Dei Genitrix?
Are you finished, brother?
Oh, I'm sorry, brother. It's never wrong to appeal to our Virgin to shield us from evil, especially in these days of ours.
Perfectly understandable, brother. But it is my intention to fulfill the task the abbot entrusted me with, and that as quickly as possible, especially in these days of ours.
Yes, of course.
Do you know all the details surrounding Anselmo's death?
Unfortunately, yes. I wouldn't have thought that such a beautiful and costly gift would bring misfortune to our abbey.
A somewhat delicate question. Do you think that a brother could have anything to do with the gatekeeper's death?
No! How dare you insinuate something like that?
The question doesn't necessarily reflect my opinion, but it would be very imprudent of me not to look into it.
That's impossible! The brothers are all different, but we're here for the same reasons. One of those is respect for one another, and the other is our dedication to God and His teachings. He has taught us to value life, both ours and that of our neighbors. How could a monk do such a terrible thing?
Lunacy?
That's no excuse. Heaven is my witness it's not so. As I already said, this is a place of peace and harmony. I'd swear on a stack of Bibles that no brother would ever do anything like that.
It's rumored that the devil had something to do with Anselmo's death. What's your opinion?
Speak softly, brother. Speak softly.
What's wrong?
Try not to mention the devil. That might lure him here.
Here? To the abbey?
No, into the kitchen. The devil already abides within these walls. The signs are clear, and Anselmo's death is a good example of that.
That means I'm not going to find anyone at this abbey who has ever had a direct encounter with the phantom.
Naturally, Brother Leonardo. Evil has many faces and can disguise itself very, very cleverly. The metal of a censer is the perfect hiding place.
I see you're very sure of yourself.
The abbot is too.
The abbot feels it's possible. That's something very different.
I believe firmly that it's so. Just as I believe we must be prepared to confront the forces of evil face to face. I thank God that you're here. You'll take care of it, won't you?
The only reason I came is to solve a mystery.
Oh!
That's all for the moment. I must go. Perhaps we can continue our conversation later.
I'd be delighted to get on with it, Brother Leonardo.
These are kegs of beer. I don't know which method of brewing is employed here, but I do know that hardly any other beer made can match up to the likes of the beer from Nuestra Señora de la Natividad. I might get a chance to try it at the Lord's Supper. A basic yet effective source of light. I have no use for that at all. The barrels there are full of wine. That reminds me of the night we spent in the monastery of San Crispin on the way here. The abbot told me that the best wine in the region came from there. It's not necessary. They're all sitting tight. That's used to seal the keg. I wouldn't spill any wine without good reason. A source of heat is required to get the alembic started. With an alembic, I can distill any kind of liquid. The outlet neck is broken. It would have to be fixed if I want to use it. It's locked. I hope the abbot considers having the roof redone, otherwise it's going to collapse soon. I can't reach it. Gravestones in bad condition. That's all I can find here, apart from cobwebs and dust. There's nothing there that could arouse my interest. A cross on a gravestone. That's better, and besides, I don't think I could move it all by myself. I don't see anything special. Looks like nothing special happened.